And it's showtime. Showtime, showtime. Go time, showtime. All right. Time to set up the dealy bobber here. YouTube says I'm live, so booyah. Small favors and the associated whatnots. Let's go ahead and crank this chat window out so the blind guy can see it from the distance that he needs to see it from. And go live chat. Yes. Okay. All right. Hopefully I'm getting better at doing this. And we'll go back over here, do our systems check. Yep. Chisel Gang, E, Brian, Synth Inferno. What's up? Welcome to the stream, guys. Okay, we're back here. Let me go ahead and get situated. Situated, he says, taking the U out of the word entirely because whatever. And say what? Why would I say that? I don't do the prompt response thing anymore, since Inferno. I got jacked on that a while back. Groucho, Fluffy X, and Winter Beard. How are you guys doing? Welcome to the stream. Okay. So we are here. Oh shit! Hold on one second, guys. First, as soon as I started, my ear starts to itch, and I'm like, okay, I gotta take the headphones off. And I know if I do that with a microphone live, it'll be all blah, 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 blah. All right. So here we are at Egret Tour. Samuel, how you doing? Welcome to the stream. So we're here at Egret Tours with a monolithic sort of... Oh, yeah, I saw your build, dude. That's sweet. That thing you did at Sanctuary. That is the biz. Link that shit up, by the way, sir. Share it with the class. Do you have enough of the whole class, Mr. Spicoli? Nick, so how's it going? Welcome to the stream. Okay, so it's raining here, as it's wont to do. What time is it? It is 1:47 p.m., so hopefully this rain will go away. Rain, go away. Come again. Never. Okay, what am I doing here? Oh, dude, I'm stealing some shit from that build. Whew. I like how you double reinforce the scaffolding with the post. That, I never thought about doing that because, you know, scaffolding's got enough support, but I never think about doing that kind of shit, that kind of extra. But I should, because it's just, you know, it's just extra visual crap, right? And Evodio, how you doing? Welcome to the stream. Okay, before we start, before I do any building, anything else, a commenter on one of my streams, on one of my videos, Rob Clark, hello Rob, if you are watching this later, hello, indicated that there might be a way to do the shack bridge sinking shit without the campfire. And he described it a bit, and I'm going to just go ahead and do what I do, which is to just fuck around things I don't understand. Hopefully that maybe something will stick. So if I understood his description correctly, what you do is you take two shack bridges. You take one and you take two and you snap them together. Now, according to his description, what he believes is the case, what he believes is going on, is when you group select this item, this object, this structure, the center part between the two shack bridges gets very, very soft. Yeah? So what I'm going to do with that is I'm going to try and duplicate what he did with what he said. This is probably completely f***ing wrong, but if it is not, it will give me some options in, it will definitely give me some options in vanilla no, because if this works, you can sink a shag bridge into just about anything, okay? So if I'm understanding it correctly, you just go like this, and you just drop it, and where the two join is where it goes in. It is not working, so I'm probably doing something quite wrong here. Yeah? Okay, so we go down, and it's the center of the piece? Is it the center of the piece? Or maybe it's two shack bridges. Doubles? If I do this one, let's see here. If I do this one, okay, it doesn't go into the center here. But what I was, from what I understood of the description of it, it was the center of the piece that did the trick. So maybe it takes two of them? Like if you do two, maybe you double it up? No. Aha! Aha! There it is. Okay, so you group select two shack bridges together, and the group selecting makes them both soft, and then you can sink them through the middle like this. How about those apples? So, if Rob, if you're watching this, thank you very much. I hope I'm doing it right. Nikita, how you doing? Welcome to the stream. So then there's that. Yeah? That's pretty interesting. So double shack bridges twice. It takes a lot of resources to do this, But it does definitely give you options that you would not otherwise have had. Now let's see the limitations of this thing here. Oh, don't do that. Let me back up a little bit. Let's see how flexible this is. Let's see. But yeah, okay, so group selecting it double gives you the ability to do. Yeah, so it works pretty much like the campfire does. I mean, the shack bridge has the campfire properties on it when you do this. Well, how about doing that? Looks like I need those gamma guns. Yeah, I always wait until Winterbird. I wait until it tells me I can't build anymore. Then I go grab them. But let's see here. What is possible with this? You can definitely sink it in there. And you could just do the whole damn thing. Look at this. I mean, you could just do the entire length of the bridge for the most part. I mean, I'm getting green just about everywhere. Sure, if I fiddled it, I could get other. But can you do it? Okay. So it has to be at an angle. It makes doing shack bridge setups easier. To a degree, Groucho. The one thing the campfire has an advantage over this is there's no extra. Right? You need a lot of room to do this, you know. But if you built the whole structure out somewhere else and then just grabbed it and dropped it wherever you wanted, how far can I pull it in there? Okay, so it doesn't want to go there? Yeah, it goes there. So it goes about half. Jesus. It goes about half the. Okay, so when the center of it gets to the edge of the original piece, that's when it jumps. But then if you pull it back over here and go back the other way. Okay, it doesn't work. So it's only the leading edge that will work, yeah? Helen, how you doing? Welcome to the stream. When he found that out, was an accident. Yeah, according to him, he was just farting around with stuff, trying to see if he could get it to duplicate it. Yeah? And stumbled across this. But yeah, this definitely works. This method is TM Rob Clark. So thank you, Rob, for your sharing of this information. Now, it doesn't work on this end, interestingly enough. But you can get a lot. Okay, so where is it there? You can get a lot of play on this thing. Now, if I go the other way. Yeah, see, if I go the other way, I have to drop it into the second. Aha! So, let's try this. Okay, so here's the trick to it, guys. Hold on one second. Conrad and Fergie, how you doing? Welcome to the stream. Okay, so here's the at least what I've discovered here. Okay, we got these two bridges, right? This one, the front one, is my anchor. Okay, the back one, as we see here, is the group selected piece. Yes. Okay, the back one will not work. You cannot put the back one into. You cannot sink the back one into anything. Right? Let's drop it down and then move it over. Yeah. So it has to be the anchor that goes in. The anchor is what goes in. So there we go. Does it work parallel? No. It does not. You have to do it, well, let's see. So the trick is, the soft piece is the anchor. Oh yeah, it totally does, dude. As long as you stick it out, because as soon as the non-anchor piece touches anything, it jumps. Right? So if you turn it around here, so you're going to make, like, you know, three-quarters bridges or whatever the frick, you would have to do the anchor. Like, I've got this thing backwards, right? Let's say I want the inner part, the lower part, to be the one. I would anchor this piece, yeah? And now I can have that centered, that dip in the middle look, like right here. Yeah? It should go. Okay, wait a minute. I'm using that as the anchor. Why is that not working? Okay, so there are some peculiarities here. So the original one jumps. But this one. Okay. Now remember, I don't understand this, so. Maybe it's that outside edge that has to be the one that works, right? Maybe it's the outside edge that's the only part that's really soft, yeah? Let's take another look at this. Okay, so if I wanted to do what Winterbeer was saying, make them parallel, right? Can I do it with this side? Oh no. Shit, go down there. Okay, it won't work that way, but it'll go in here. So you can make them, oh no, that's right, parallel. it can't touch that second piece, right? Because as soon as it touches that second piece, it hops. But you can do this and do that. So if I grab the other one as the anchor, which is this one. Yeah. Stella, how you doing? Welcome to the stream. We're experimenting with a new technique. One that Czech did not come up with. This one is courtesy of Rob Clark. Okay, so for whatever reason, that piece does not like to snap. Now, can I get the other side? What I'm trying to do here, guys, is the inside. I'm trying to get that lower half, the left half, the kind of dips. I'm trying to get that to be the center of the parallel structure here. And there's one right here. So if I do it here, it hops. It does not like... That lower section does not like to be group selected, but if I do it this way, the outer section does. Yeah. The outer section will definitely... Yeah. We slide it in. And you can't quite get it to the end. So you can't make them completely parallel. Vulgar, how you doing? Welcome to the stream. So Winterbird, the answer to your question is sort of. You can sort of do it. You can't get it all the way. Unless maybe we pull it out a little bit here. No, not just hops. Well. You can get them close. You can get them close. But you can't get them quite all the way in. Now, what happens if I try it from underneath? Because as we all know, as we are all familiar with, view angle is... Justin, how you doing? Welcome to the stream. View angle sometimes makes a huge amount of difference. So... we do this, crank it up to there, okay, that looks pretty close from under here, yeah, kind of close. What does it look like on the top? Let's go ahead and examine it in the dark here and see what we get. Well, it's pretty close, Winterbeard. You can't sink it as aggressively as you could with the campfire. But you can definitely get a parallel double-sided walkway with it. That is friggin' fascinating. Okay. Again, if you're joining the stream late, or if you're just joining the stream now, I'm not going to say late because you're on time. I simply started early. We are experimenting with a shack bridge sinking technique that Rob Clark described to Shaq and I in the comments. And I'm trying to figure out the limitations of this thing to see how it works. But so far, it is absolutely promising. You can get it to how far? Yeah, you can sink it all the way. You can make T-intersections out of this thing, pretty much, as long as it goes green, but it doesn't go green here. And that's fine. That's fine. So you get about what looks like maybe half of it. Maybe. And it's, you know, it's the typical shack bridge fiddling shit, right? But yeah, it has potential. It has potential. Now, the question is... But if the... Okay, Stella, I'm assuming you hit enter too soon. So hit it up. Let's test this out. That's what we do here. Yeah, so you can do it here on this other one. Kinda, yeah. So you can go there, sure. Rotate it, yeah. But if they snap, you could offset it and do it even if red. If they snap, you can offset it and do it even if red. Like, okay, if I'm understanding this correctly, what you're saying is put them close enough, take the one out. When am I doing any building? Pretty soon, dude. I want to experiment with this little tool here because I'm fascinated by this. But yeah, we're gonna get to it pretty quick. But yeah, look at that. You can just okay. So it can't go there. So it's got to be at a pretty cute angle for the most part. And if I turn around here and go this way, go down a little bit. So yeah, you can fiddle it. You can fiddle it to 45 degrees on the edges and pretty much anywhere along the length of it. Not there though. Okay, how about over here? Down here? Yeah. Okay, so you can go here as well. So you can get some pretty good. You could pull it further out and snap in the extra. That's a good question, Stella. Let me see if I can't Let me try that, and then I'll reset this, and we'll go to daytime. So we'll just put this thing, like, right here, yeah? How aggressive are these things snapping, I guess, is the question that we're asking for, yeah? Well, Stella for the win. I heard it. So you can just get it completely perpendicular if you want to, yeah? Absolutely, okay. So that gives us the possibility of doing Winterbeard's perpendicular, yeah? By group selecting this thing here. No, it's okay, Stella. It's all right. It can be kind of complicated to explain these things sometimes. Believe me, I get you. So we can do it like that. Yeah. Push it all the way down. Get it lined up. Get lined up as best we can. And Captain Drastic, how you doing? Welcome to the stream. Okay, now the sun's coming out, of course, because of course it is. Okay, so that is shit. Let's just do it from this angle. It's just easier. Yeah, it's a lot easier because now it fucking works. So yeah, that's another little peculiarity of the shack bridge. Okay, so Winterbeard, is that your parallel? Let's see. Let's take a look here. Glad I get it. Well, the thing is, Stella, I'm used to doing funky shit, so when you say funky things, I'm like, okay, I'm getting it. So there you go, Winterbeer. You can do it. You can do it from the bottom. If you can group select from the bottom, you can absolutely get a parallel in there. So that's good. Now, will this trick work with other things snapped to it? Like, can I get a floor in there? Shit, come here. Now, nothing snaps to these, right? Can I snap a floor to this thing? How many floors? Yeah, I got this floor. Okay, the floors do not snap to this. Can I just place it? No. But, if I can place it on top of here, right? Just place it there. Now let's take this and see if I can't just use this, sink it right into that floor piece. Because if I can get the thing up on top of the shack bridge, knowing that this will sink, in theory, no, it will not go. It will not go. Now, if I take these out, will that stay floating? Yes, it will. Okay. Now, I know I can just group select normally anyway with a scaffold. No, the whole point of this, Stella, is that you can do it without DLC. That's, yeah, look at that. See? Look at this shit. I saw it. I know I saw it. So now the front one doesn't go. Now the anchor doesn't go, but the trailer does. Yeah. But it won't be. But yeah, so the whole point of this is that you can do it without DLC. That's the trick to this particular object. These are all vanilla no DLC pieces. Yeah, okay, so it doesn't work that way. But hey, we learned something new, man. How about those apples, yeah? You know, I should probably save these because I'm going to be building more shit in the water anyways. So, yeah. Have any toy like the paw for us to fall out? Dude. Eat a lot. People say it a lot. And I am shocked by this, but I will take it. I will take it. Okay, so now we're going to do some building. So, have I missed anybody coming in? Yeah, we're all about the happy accidents here, man. Absolutely all about the happy accidents. So, Rob, thank you very much. I can see how that works. It has potential. And we will, I will be definitely playing with that on the vanilla no DLC build. So group selecting pairs of shack bridges. Lady X, how you doing? Welcome to the stream. Thank you. thank you. There's no mistakes. I don't make mistakes, but I make errors. I make lots of errors, but I don't make mistakes. Errors are when you fail because you didn't know better. Mistakes are when you fail because you did. It seems like semantics, but it makes a difference. And, okay. So what we're going to do today is we're going to try and finish up whatever the hell this thing is. And, looking at this, we've got that thing. I don't like that. If I do, yeah, I can't put a stairway here. Although I'd like to. Wasn't wrong, you're misinformed. Exactly. Well, you can be incorrect without being wrong, dude. There are shades of meaning here. Okay, so this is pretty much done. This just needs to be furnished, so we're gonna leave this be. This is. Now I could swear that you could snap things to this at some point. Up to this thing. I don't know why I think that. I saw it somewhere maybe? But I don't think the interior's got any snap points. Yeah, no, it doesn't. I thought you could though. I don't know why I think that. Eh, whatever. Okay. So this is done. The engineer's shack is done. This whatever the hell this is gonna be is done. Yeah. Okay. And we have this. So what are we gonna be doing here? Well, let's get some power to it. Let's do that first. And since we have a perfect spot to put a power conduit right here, let's put that there. Let's get to building shit. Also, someone asked me recently before I started the stream, I didn't have time to respond to the comment. They asked if I'm on Xbox or PC or PS4. I'm on Xbox. It was a comment posted on the Starlight Vanilla Rebuild. And what the hell? There's no nav mesh on the top of this? Oh, no collision at all, you bastards. All right. Fine. Build two more floors up. Dalton, how you doing? Welcome to the stream. Okay. And, well, maybe I can probably do this. This is floating over the water, right? Yeah. Okay. All right. There we go. And then we grab this. And now, of course, it sinks to its... It sinks to its full length, he said, suggestively. And, but anyway, he was asking if I was on an Xbox or PS4, and I'm on Xbox. For anyone who is still curious about the... It's gotta be higher. The platform that I am currently using. I do build on PC, but this is not that character. K-L-M-N-O-P-Q-R-S-T. Alright, down you go. And in you go. And... Boop! Now it's built and supported. And is it visible from underneath? It sticks out a little bit, but that's fine. It's fine. Okay, and that one's on a rug. I gotta remember that. Okay. Got that one. Get some power up in this piece. Come on. What the hell, dude? There we go. And you. Okay. And then you. Oh, that's what I gotta do. I gotta do something with this part right here, don't I? That's gonna come up every time. So, JPEG, how's it going? Welcome to the stream, sir. It's fine. Merch just the beginning. You guys in the merch things, man. That's, you know, I mean, on the one hand, yeah, it'd be kind of cool. But on the other, it starts to ease into the spot where I'm like, okay, I'm not comfortable with how complicated this channel shit's getting. You know? It's like that's sort of, hold on a second. God, yeah. Jeez. That's getting a little more too into the serious part of the program. Let's see. No prefabs. Yeah, it's not gonna snap there, but I bet I could fire that bad boy in there. And if I could, you know, I always wondered about this piece right here. Can you snap stuff to the outside of this thing? Can you snap a roof to the outside of this? Because if I do this, let me look at this. If I do this, it makes a sort of entry for the bar, yeah? And, maybe with BE. Well, that's the thing, I've never tried it. So what I'm going to do is, I think, if I'm going to use... I'm going to use this piece. It's got to be snapping to that, has to be snapping to that corner piece there. Very interesting. But if I use this piece here, is that snapping? No, I fired that. No, it does snap. Okay. Well, take that out. And where did it go? I put it away. I didn't take it out. Okay, so it's not going to snap there. But if I put it here, I can keep this open. Or no, I should close it off. I should still keep it closed off because that way it has a little windowed seating area for the hoi polloi and the associated whatnots. Give me an idea. I need to bookmark this spot. All right. Well, bookmark this spot. But yeah, but you can see. So Stella, before you bookmark the spot, notice that this thing is kind of off center. It's not quite touching. Right, I did the fire glitch with it, but it doesn't touch. So maybe that's why, like, it has an exposed snapping surface, which makes me wonder. You can't get on the outside, but you can definitely get on the inside. Okay, let me test that out really quick after I do this. I'm gonna put this here, yeah, and look at it like this. So if I do this here, that'll give it a traffic flow on the left. It'll give an exposed patio on the right. Yeah, we'll do it. We'll use this piece. Okay. So we do that there, and yeah, you can definitely see it is snapped to that. No, it's not. What the hell is it snapping to, guys? What on earth is this piece snapped to? It's not snapped to this because that's too tall. Is it snapping to this railing? No? What on earth? The warehouse mesh? This thing here? It could be, but the problem is this mesh is snapped pretty much to this. The shack foundation. It's too tall. It's snapping to something above itself, but what? Not the ladder. Not this thing, because it's not straight. What on earth is this thing snapping to? It's not snapping to this railing, because the railing's perpendicular. Is this the shack bridge? No? Because the thing is, what's really screwing me up is it's straight. Well, no, it's not straight. It's a little bit off. It's not quite lined up on that. So it's snapping to something that's higher up. This is so weird. I have no idea what this is snapped to, dude. Okay, anyway, to hell with it. I have no idea what this snapped to. Okay, roofs do not snap on... Roofs do snap on the outside. So there you go. Roofs do snap on the outside. Okay, so let's go ahead and get our mojo working here on this delightful piece here. Yes, and then we take you, jam you right through the bottom there, and I hear a storm coming, which is fantastic, and then I want it to go, yeah, I do want it to go here. Where did I put it? Kind of in the corner? Okay, so right about here should do the trick, I think. So random, but Friday was a really fun stream. Was it? E, what was fun about it? We did the Tuesday build, right? We got our half hour in, which was yay. And then farted around. I mean, I didn't really do much of anything other than fumblingly try to explain the conceptual backdrop behind building Scrappy. Oh, this left stick. God, I wish it was more sensitive. Is that right? Does that look about right? Now, let's see. MC, how you doing? Welcome to the stream. It's casually chaotic. It's like, I should have come up. Hey, how you doing, Smoke? I should have, welcome to the stream, sir. In hindsight, I probably should have had some sort of outline or script or talking points or whatever, but of course, cluelessly, I did not. And let's do, can I snap a scaffolding just straight up to this? Probably not, yeah. I always forget what scaffolding snaps to. I mean, other than itself, you know. I know it snaps to itself. But, well, I can just kind of place it here. Just freestyling. All right, all right. You like the, you like the improvisational nature of the thing there. That's fair. That's fair. It just felt a little bit, like you said, it felt a little bit too chaotic for my taste. It's like, okay, I feel like I wanted to cover things that I forgot to because I was just so scatterbrained. How we do? Oh, there's a little gap, but it's not much. That'll be fine. It'll be fine. It'll be fine. You know what? Let's just put the... penis equivalent on this thing. Yeah, we'll do that. And then we'll do, will scaffolding snap in here? You do. Perfect. Okay. I'm just gonna put a metal tube. It is a series of tubes. We need something a little bit different for the top, and having shit kinda hanging off definitely suffices. You can't really tell it's floating from back here if you go up this way and look under it. Well, it's almost sitting on there, so pretty good. You started watching me, very good YouTube. Well, thanks, man. I like sharing things. It's like, look, you know, people say, I can't build like this. It's like, no, you totally can, man. You totally can. You can totally build like this. If a shaved ape like me can do this shit, man, so can you. We can all do this. Okay, so this gives me more bedrooms, which is nice. It gives me an ugly form factor, which, again, also nice. We have two ways up. Nice. We have the luxury room. We got some scrap rooms. I can just make this just straight up barracks and bunks and shit. Okay, so that's good. We got that. Now I need my ladders, which are over here. So for the Tuesday build, I'm just going to update the mod when it's finished. Yeah, I probably jumped the gun on telling y'all about that stuff because it's gonna be 6 months, maybe a year before I get it done, dude. There's too much to figure out. Although I am considering what's taking the time is trying to make the building pieces statics, putting those in, putting the decorations and shit in. That's easy. All I gotta do is find a similar thing in the construction kit, duplicate it, change the model, and I'm done. It's like, okay, well, whatever. But doing the building pieces requires a lot more fussing about, fiddling about. Because you have to put a nav mesh on there, you gotta make sure it's got snap points and blah 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 blah. Neil, how you doing? Welcome to the stream. Let me see here, Tuesday build. Loki, how you doing? Welcome to the stream. That's what I refer to myself. Well, yeah, dude. I mean, you know, from a certain perspective, that's pretty much what we are, right? Well, the ones of us who shave, the ones who do not, who shall remain nameless, do not have to worry about that particular nomenclature. But I buy that. Shaved ape. Oh, shit. okay, so the ladder has a very large grab radius. Oops. I'd buy that for $1. You've been here a while, just lurking. Okay, well, welcome to the stream anyway. Welcome to the maniac, welcome to the chaos of chat. We'll do that. Welcome to the chaos of chat, sir. And then we got that, and then, oh, you know what? I'll just put another one over here. Okay, this is kind of pissing me off. This is kind of pissing me off right here. This flat-ass scaffolding floor, and this flat-ass scaffolding floor. It begs to have something put on top of it, but there's no way to get to it. No way to get to it. Oh. Dun, dun, dun. You gotta let it go for No Shave November. I tried that once, JPEG. And as a biological male who is not particularly hirsute, By day, ten? I just looked like I had mange, dude. I was like, you know, no. I looked like I was on a bad drug bender, and I'm like, no. So yeah, I am not someone who can grow a full, luxurious pelt. Oh man, it's the base of a stairwell. It is, but the problem is Winterbeard. I was looking at that when it first started, right? It's like there's nowhere to go because this is a stairwell. So if I put any stairs attached to any of this stuff, you can't get to it. The scaffolding's in the way, or the stairs are here. I painted myself in the corner. Make a bridge to that side later, like across from the longhouse. Oh, now you're cooking with gas. Let's check the elevation. You gotta check the elevation. It has potential. It has potential. I probably would have to snap stairs underneath it. 6-Pack Cartoon Network. Yes, that is precisely what this is. It is a very casual sort of... Okay, so for now, well, with these things glitched in there, there's no way I'm going to be able to snap. Because this is just a shack floor, right? This is not a scaffolding floor. Let's see if it'll let me get away with. Probably will not let me snap anything to it, but you never know. When I do weird shit like this, you can never tell how it's going to go. Okay, you know what? I'm going to start using metal floors. No, not that. Concrete floors. Okay, I got a ton of these things already. Okay, so it'll snap. I saw that. Now the trick is, will it snap through here? It will not. Can I go around? Look, it's Dima's memory game. Almost. Nick, how's it going? Welcome to the stream. I was thinking Offspring. Yeah, I whatever comes to mind, dude. I have my synapses are so completely cooked from being old and abusing my body when I was younger. It's anybody's guess what the fuck's gonna come out of my mouth sometimes. And no love there, but as JPEG has instructed, a scaffolding will sometimes snap. Two. Scaffolding will sometimes snap where other things do not. Because it does not have the entire, its collision is just slightly smaller. So, Jax, how's it going? Welcome to the stream. What do I think of Fallout 76? I do not think of it at all, MC. It is not a game I was ever interested in because I do not play online-only games. So, I just assume it's going to be fun for people who play it, and I'm not going to be one of them, and I just pretty much leave it at that. So we've got that sticking off the side. And I guess I could, well, if I move this, can I snap it back in? Yeah. Okay, I can do that. So let's see if I can't get her abuse synapses. Yeah, right. Let's just have plus one for poor choices. Huh? How about that? La da ta da 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 da. Now, how does it look on the inside? That's the trick. Does it stick through the ceiling too much? Well, it's not terrible. I could cover that up. Yeah. You don't care about this really bad. Well, I know a lot of people that play it, and I watch them talking about it, and the people who play it love the fuck out of it, MC. But it's not the type of Fallout game I want. And that's not the type of game I want to play. So, it's just, gonna need... Okay, so that, I think... Let me look at this from a distance here. That, I can live with that as the support for this thing. Yeah? But yeah, MC, I mean, it was never a game for me anyway, so I don't really care. It's just like, okay, y'all have fun with it, enjoy and stuff. And yeah, I could probably hide it on the inside. Now, how does it look on the other side here? That doesn't look bad at all. Now it gives us some potential, right? It gives us possibilities. It gives us a reason to use this thing, which is a scaffolding floor. Now, oh my god, I can resnap that. Look at that. Look at that. I love it when a plan comes together. Even when it makes absolutely zero sense that it should have. You know? Okay, well, anybody snap to here? No. Okay, so can I get the concrete to snap to you? Not floors. Miscellaneous. No. Can I get scaffolding to snap to it? Process of elimination. Well, I can't get it to snap, but I can just get it to just place. So we'll just place it there. Fuck it, whatever. It's fine. It's fine. Do that there, and then we'll snap a wood one here. Right. And then, yeah, so I guess I'll just keep building wood. Okay, nobody's gonna snap to that. So I'm gonna need concrete for that one, yeah? Yeah, we'll do that. Then we'll go back to wood. Okay, so a little tip to doing, scrappy looking railings that are variegated. Basically, when I start building lots of wood things, what I'll do is I'll go wood wall 1, wood wall 3, wood wall 2, wood wall 4. And then I go back to 1, so that way I get the variegation that I need, because these two slat railings don't... So these two are never adjacent, and it helps to have a pattern 1, 3, 2, 4, 1, 3, 2, 4, knit 1, purl 2, etc., etc., etc. So that way, if I want to continue the railing, all I gotta do is look at if I want to continue the sequence, all I gotta do is look at that first railing, and I know which one's next. Yeah. So, that's my cheesy workaround for that kind of thing. Yeah. Okay. And then I guess up here would be an ideal space for a guard post, but which way will he face? That way? This way, huh? Yeah. We'll have him face that way. Too much OCD. Well, JPEG, normally I agree with you, but sometimes when I'm in a hurry, I'm like, fuck it, I just need a wall. I can get it up there really quick. It's really fast, and it looks sufficiently random. And then later on, if I don't like it, I can fix it. But that's like the default. Okay, I need something in a hurry. I don't want to think about this too much. Fuck it. Bang. Done. And, you should be able to go out much further than this. Okay. So let's get scrap you. Let me get no, you know what? Yeah, let's just put this one up here. Yeah. Okay, I got a flat spot down there. So we'll do this. Right. We'll get our ashtray out. Now I remember, by the way, so building in vanilla without DLC, I remember now why I keep reaching for the ashtray, because it is one of the few pieces that's in vanilla, and it's the first one, and it's fast to get to. So that's why I keep using the ashtray, guys. In case you ever wondered, care, whatever, I don't care. Oh, well, maybe I should have not built that other one. Da-da-da. Take off the railings. Oh, yeah. Let's see if this works. Let me see if I can get this to work first, and then I will do that. But as I recall, doing it this way helped me, no, it doesn't want to behave. How fascinating. Normally this works really good. Okay. Hopefully they snap back when I put this thing back up there, but who knows, we'll see. What am I doing with the top of the building and the stairs going down? Jax, that is an excellent question. And not to sound too wonky or weird, I literally don't have any idea. I don't have any clue. Once I start building on it and I start seeing what I'm doing with it, then I will figure it out and go with it from there. But I tend to build, as you've seen, somewhat randomly. I fix problems as I go. So I will probably do something with this roof. I just have no idea what it is yet. I have no clue. And that's because that's part of the fun for me, is trying to figure out where I'm going and what I'm doing with what I've got. Which is why my builds tend to look like they do. Is that high enough? No. It is not. That will be high enough. Okay, back in the saddle again. Da-da-da. Rubbo, how you doing? Welcome to the stream. Make it like a loading area? I don't know, we'll see. I might just make it houses, shit. I might just do the whole thing. Because now the prisoner's off the roof. Once, oops, don't do that. If they don't have a place to spawn in, they'll never go back up there again. You know, or they'll be up on the higher roof or whatever. I wonder if they'll spawn on top of a roof that is at the build limit. Like, will it let them spawn outside the build area? Probably, huh? Because they seem to spawn everywhere friggin' else. Okay, so it's not quite 90 degrees. Yeah, I guess that'll do. Now let's see if the railings will snap back. They probably will not. But if they do, it'll make my day. And they... Oh, good. And you are the problem child. Yes. Yeah, you're the problem child. So you're going to go there then. And you're going to go here. No? No? Well, I guess I could just leave it like that, eh? There's no reason to put things in the front now, because it's got that corner. Yeah, it has its own siding. Okay, so I wonder, can I get... Well, this won't go on that corner. It's way too close, yeah? Well, I'll go that way. I saw it turn green briefly, but... Yeah, I don't want to point it that way. Well, I can do it this way. Yeah, make it turn that way, which is kind of dumb. Yeah, you know what? I'm going to put that goddamn turn on there. But I need some... I need some distance. And I need my astro back. Thank you. It's fine. Yes, it's fine. Sometimes though, Helen, sometimes though, I gotta tell you. Sometimes I want it to be a little bit closer to being cool rather than just fine. It does happen. It's not common. But there are some instances where I can be actually particular, which is peculiar, I'm sure. But it is what it is. Is three gonna be two? Is two gonna be long enough? Two should be long enough. Where's your center? Your center is right there. Yeah? Right. And that is... Okay. Three. And then we go up. What I'm playing right now. Hi there, welcome to the stream, and thank you very much. Thank you very much. It's looking like something. It's absolutely looking like something. That is a safe descriptor of all my builds ever. It definitely looks like something. Like if somebody hands you their new kid, you're like, yep, that's a baby. But yeah, you can't go wrong with that one. That's always going to be true. That is certainly a baby. Da-da-da. Come on. You can do it. Why won't you pick this up? You're right next to it, dude. This is weird. There it goes. Okay. Da da da. Now we run all the way around. Yada da da da. Okay. And then go down. And That looks about right, and it won't place. Okay. That means I need another rug. Yeah, I'll put this back on there. Do another rug. Up you go. And of course, now it's too tall, and it won't bring in place. Well, that'll have to be good enough. Up you go. Now you won't go, huh? Shit. Well, let's do it again then. Center's here. You know what? The hell, I'm not even going to use this thing. If it jumps, it jumps. I don't care. No one care. When someone hands me a baby, I just, what do you want me to do with this? Yeah. Sing a vaguely complimentary thing and then handing it back is usually my technique. Okay, and there you are. And there you are. Yeah. You're probably gonna hop like crazy when I take you out too. Okay. So before I do this, let's quick save before I start taking rugs out. I got three of them here, and I have no idea which way this bastard's gonna hop. Oh no. That's not good. Okay, so it looks decent from there. Shit, I can't see it from this side. How much does it hang off? Oh, it doesn't hang off too much. Okay, that's acceptable. I can live with that. Quick save. Your spelling is not working right. That's fine, lady. That's fine, Helen. We're fine. Everything's fine. We're all good. We don't worry too much about that stuff. And drop through. Right? And... well, they both drop through. Nice. So that means I should be able to go upstairs here. And get them out from underneath. Or, you know, not. Okay, well, I guess now I know how Bethesda got those stairs stuck in the ceiling at Easy City Downs. Yeah, whatever, it's fine. They're patching a hole in the roof. That's what they're doing. That's my story, and I'm sticking to it. Galaxy Punk, how you doing? Welcome to the stream. Just stopping by to chat. Well, thanks, man. Thank you very much. I'm glad you enjoyed them. I hope they're useful for you, and I hope they get some. You know what? Nah. Let's load. Let's load this back out and see what we get here. Put a floor on the outside for the rug. You know what? I just now noticed that JPEG. And you know, that's the type of stuff that I never think about doing. Ever. I'm like, okay, I approach the problem directly from one side. It's like, it doesn't occur to me to do that. Oh god. You know what? Shit, now that you got that in my head, I'm totally doing that. If I even can. Can I do that now? Let's find out. Can I get a little floor snapped? Jesus God, dude. Why did it? Ugh! I wish you'd have flagged it so I could have seen that, dude. Because, oh my God, this would have made my life so much easier. Remember? Okay, so shaved ape. Okay, guys, I'm telling you. That is actually not a... So the roof line goes through a rug. Interesting that the whole top of it is easily placeable, though. Huh, interesting. I have to remember that. Sorry, not sorry. It's all good, man. It is all good. It is all good. This is why community builds work better than solo builds. Because we all have different ways of approaching the same problem, and sometimes the oh, jeez, look at that. All that fucking work I could have just done in this. Herpader. Seriously. Thank you, JPEG. Oh, don't do that. No. This. And this. Yeah. Okay. So now the turret's actually in the right spot. It doesn't hang over. And, yeah. Duh. All right, let's put these away. Let's go ahead and get some daylight back out here. La-di-da-di. Okay. Let's see what we get here on the old hoo-ha. And let's see what we got here on the profile. Because now that I built this thing, and I don't even know what it looks like. Oh, and if you weren't on the stream on Friday, was I talking about it when JPEG stream? I don't remember what it was. But one of the reasons I realized one of the reasons I build so fast, yeah, because everybody's like, "Oh my God, you build so fast!" Like, well, I build fast because I need to see what I'm building to know whether I'm gonna like it or not. So I've gotten accustomed. Shit, that thing absolutely goes through the back of the friggin' guard tower, doesn't it? I didn't even look. You know what? I don't even care. The guard's gonna be standing here the whole time. He's gonna be standing here the whole time. The whole hoo-ha. Okay. But the reason I build as fast as I do is because I need to see when I'm building to know what it is that I'm going to build. Yeah? And then I step back and look at it and go, okay, does this suck? Do I like it? Do I not like it? Whatever. And if it sucks, I tear it down and do something else to it. Or modify it and, you know, make it closer to what I think it should look like. But I have a problem visualizing. I don't know what it's going to look like until I can actually see it. So that's why I build as fast as I do. So I can actually get things built. Okay, so we've got this here, right? Let's do something with this promenade thing. Let's put this rogue ashtray away, or just scrap it, because why not? So now I want to do something with this. We've got this going. This thing is pretty much... Let me look at this thing again. Let me just look at it. Yeah. Yeah, that looks... That looks pretty much... If it offends me, can I put a railing inside the guard post gapped out to hide the turret? Yeah, I probably could, JPEG, but I'm like, you know what? Or I could just put the rugs back out and just float the turret a little bit more. Or even, you know, take another... Just group select a... I could campfire another piece right in there to give it a little, you know, ledge that sticks out, but it's fine. The guards are always going to be standing there. In my builds, one guard per station and nobody ever moves, so it'll be okay. That's the kind of slop I can live with. But this looks... Now, the only problem is it looks kind of half-ass on this side. So what I'm going to do probably is make the guards' quarters stick out over this water. Yeah. Just to sort of hide that gap and make a little swimming corridor here. Oh, mod slop. Forgot I had the last time I played the Fallout was the modded builder, so the water's clearer when it should not be. But yeah, if this is all blocked off in here, that means anybody trying to swim in here and get salt is gonna get their asses kicked, because they're not gonna be able to get out of the water. Except for way over here. Okay. Alright, before I do that, let me go ahead and finish tricking out the inside of... Yeah, I'll just box that off with a warehouse wall or something. It'll be fine. Oh! My light's on! I love the little lighting fixture! It's so cute. Okay. So then this will be the entry for the... Can I snap a wall on this? If I could snap... Yes, okay, I want that wall with the chicken wire in it. This one. Yeah, that's the business. So that way, you've got the inside of the bar, which is going to be very, very limited. But now I can use this understair space a lot easier. Because the stair space, the traffic pattern for the stairs is going to go up this way. So then I can use this area for, I don't know, benches or something? Speaking to my lightning build style, that's one of the reasons I enjoy watching builders build. Yeah, how people solve problems. Yeah, exactly. I am with you, JPEG. That's why I like watching them as well. It's like I watch how you build, and I'm like, okay, what? I can't figure out what you're even doing. And that's exclusive, by the way, exclusive of the quapa manipulations, because I don't understand that thing in the slightest. But you do it so fast because you know how to do it, right? So it's like, I'm gonna, like, okay, he's using the stick again. All right, I got it. He's using the stick again. Let's see. We got bleed through here. So I guess I could just put one light, what, here? I could just use this industrial light and stick it right there. Yeah. That'll give me light in there. And then carriage light back here. Which doesn't actually stick to anywhere on this doorway. Look at this. Boy, this doorway back sucks, guys. Wow. Well, it kind of does there. And up. Okay, so not there. Ooh, that's a very narrow window of opportunity right there. It's a very narrow window. Wow, that is, sorry guys, this is really delicate work here. Yeah. Okay, so that's as high as it wants to go. Yeah, that lights it up decently. I mean, this is not going to be... I guess I'll have to wait till nighttime to see how this works, but I think that will do it. I think that will be sufficient for those things. And then this thing, of course, will get its own light. Yeah. Put this thing right in there. Yeah. Okay. A little accent lighting there. That lights up the whole inside there. Very good. Here. Now see, here's going to be tricky because I got a light in upstairs already, yeah? And if I put a light down here, it's going to bleed to the floor. Big time. So then what that means is I need to punt and put a carriage light on the outside over here. So that way I can get the bleed through on this light inside the entry area. Yeah? But you, come on, man. There. Yeah, there we go. See, just a little bit of bleed through there. Not much, but enough to where you can see what's going on in there. Okay. So now what does it look like? A little monolithic. But part of the problem is the back of it is so flat. I think. Yeah, part of it is this back. It's very, very flat on the back here. And unfortunately, it is symmetrical. That's part of the problem too. So we need something to break up the sight lines on this thing, I think. Okay, so if we have a guard station here, the guards can technically come back in through this way, yeah? They could come from the main area here down the bridge. So I don't need to put an entrance on the other side. They can come through here, and then they're on the dock. So then that means this stairway is pretty much superfluous, but I can't move it. And this is the one I put in here, yeah, to get out of the water. So I'm going to move this thing over here a little bit, which plays very nicely with the side of the dock, for your reference. Very nicely. Look at that. Look at that shit. Just, wow. Okay. Not need to go a little bit lower. A little bit lower. Let's push it down a little bit. Oh, look at that. Oh, crap. Come on. You just did it, dude. Ah, this is some fiddly shit here. Well, I guess that'll work. Yeah, that'll work. And I can get out of the water just fine, right? Yeah, once the water's murky, you won't be able to see that it's floating. A metal stairway is floating in the water. So yeah, you come down here, you come down here. So if I come out of the water, and then just go to the left and up. Okay, that makes sense traffic-wise. Which means... We're gonna need to wall this off. Gonna need to wall it off. It's already getting twisty too, which is what I like. I like it a lot. Okay. Time to move all our tools over here so I can see what I'm doing. Okay, come here, you. Never. What? Why won't you grab the pillar, dude? Come on. There we go. Oh, Jesus. Oops. There we go. So you drop it in and out kids' bedtime. It's all good, man. It's all good. We will be here when you need us, dude. We'll be here. It's all good in the hood, man. It's all good in the hood. Enjoy what you can. And, okay, so I want. Want in one hand and shit in the other. See which one fills up first. Whoops! Didn't want to do that. Okay. So what we're gonna do then... Yeah, this is a problem here because you can just jump down here. Well, you just ignore it and just leave it wide the f*** open because who cares? Start building up my guard station here. Which would be what? What's it gonna be? It's the dirt. Okay, so it's the dirt here and the dirt here. Well, I guess if I could build it here. Not terrible. Alright, let's work back to front. We're going back to front. Be AFK. Alright, Javik. Be sure to holler back at me if I do something stupid. Well, we'd be here all day if you did that, right? Do that. We'll use marble because marble seems to play nicer with this stuff. And yeah, let's do this. And then where does it go? Here? Yeah. Alright. So up you go, big fella. What? Okay. Of course. Of course. The only spot where there's a friggin' a gap between the two dirt piles, and I find it. Come on, go down. Is it not far enough away? Try this. Ooh, Joseph, how you doing? Welcome to the stream, sir. How are you doing today? Okay. So what I'm doing is I'm building a little guard post, shack, station, whatever. And not having a lot of luck with this particular object. Although what I should be doing, honestly, is this. Should be doing is this. Because I know, well, I don't know, but I've been told that when you go with a shack bridge underneath something, you often get a lot more play than you do otherwise. was that? Not terrible, but not great. Right here, maybe? How's that? Yeah, that's a little bit better. Okay. Do that, and... and then I know, since JBIC told us back in the day, that you can't snap these to floors, but you can snap floors to these as long as the floors are full size. Which means, with that snapped in place, we can build order the crap out of this thing and snap crapo floors to it. Danina? Damn it, I had it right the first time, then I screwed it up, didn't I? Welcome to the stream. How's it going? Okay. Do that there. Is that tall enough for my purposes? Yeah, that blocks things off really nice. Oh shit. Gotta group select it. Gotta group select it. Danina. Thank you. Danina. Perfect. And thank you very, very much for giving me a phonetic on it, man. Because I just, oh god, I try. I want to do it right. Okay. So if we do that, and drop this. That seems kind of low. So a guard standing on top of this thing can see... Dario, how you doing? Welcome to the stream. No mods. No vanilla, dude. Vanilla all day and twice on Sunday. And today is Sunday, so it's twice on Sunday. You should try my last name. Oh, you gotta do that to me, huh, Danina? Okay, you gotta do that to me? Oh, God, no, I'm gonna pass. Let's just assume that I would butcher it and go from there, okay? Oh, man. Buzzbot? Wow, yeah, I would not have gotten that in the first 10 tries, Danina. Absolutely would not have gotten on the first 10 tries. Buzzbuck. Because I would have gone bow. That would have been my first instinct. Bows. Go bows. Ah, yeah. Alright, so the guard station's up that tall. And it blocks a lot of the stuff in the back, but that's not terribly bad. In fact, if it's isolated like this, then it will make more sense. He said, speculatively. Right, and it doesn't snap to those. Da-da-da-da-da-da. Move over here, so then I can group select the floor. Up into, oops, don't do that. Okay, good. And then... just give me something I can group select now. Okay. And then... well... not exactly what I was after. Maybe if I go over here? Can do it that way? Sure. Remember the lumber mill builder couldn't figure out what to do with the truck beds? With the flatbeds? With those two flatbeds side by side? Yes. Oh, I've got scars on that one, Danina. That echo leg thing is going to haunt me for a long time. See, I can't even see this thing here. Let's lower it. You found an example of one out in the world of a flatbed build? Oh, I've seen stuff built on the flatbeds of trucks. I copied a gunner. There was a gunner thing where they had like a workshop on the back one. up on an overpass. I think it's on the overpass over there by Ten Pines. But I stole that form factor for the Mega Bill, the Starlight Mega Bill. That's where the armor vendors were working. But did you see something else that has that kind of application, that has some other use for it? Because I'm always up for stealing a new ship from Bethesda. That is a fact. That is absolutely a fact. Where is it at? I want it to be, like, here. Yeah? Yeah. Right. Come on. Right there. Right. Okay. Then, okay, so now this thing is getting more and more lumpy. And, wow. Getting a little chuggy there, too. Getting a little chuggy here, too. So if I do it this tall, I could probably just put a stairway on it. Okay. Let's push it as far as it can. Put it there. So if it goes there, that's too far forward. Oops, don't do that. See, here's the mid-game fiddly part. We're putting that first piece down is the time-consuming, irritating, aggravating, but once it's down, it'll work great. Okay, but if the guard's there, if we put him at this height, yeah? Yeah, that's a good elevation. I can live with this elevation. What do you think, guys? This is good, yeah? This is a reasonable height for a guard to see over into spots, and he can see into the second floor over there. So, yeah, this ain't terrible. Okay, this is a good height. So now what we're going to do is we're going to move this, which will snap back. Come here, you. And we're going to pump with the scaffolding floors. Now that JPEG taught me that trick, I'm like, okay, let's just keep doing this, eh? Yeah, baby. Because now, with that there, I could probably snap the framework right to the bottom of it. Just like that. And now I've got support. And then this thing here can get, well, hell no, I'm on a scaffolding tower. Let's give it a ladder. Let's give it a ramp. Where's the short stairs? Yeah? Are these the short ones? No. Where are the short ones? I won't snap onto that. Scaffolding, no, it doesn't like that thing. So I guess I'm going to go back to wood. Well, let's see if warehouse will work. Huh. Warehouse works. Okay, so now the guard's got a little ramp. And then, you know what? Okay, so that will not snap back there, but if I take this off, that will snap back. Okay. If that snaps there, and then this should snap to this, yeah? Yeah, okay. So that will still snap back there, so I can still put that back together. Let's put, let's do some more scaffolding, because while we're here, I don't know if it'll snap to this thing, though. It does. La-dee-dee-dee-dee-dee-dee-dee. Damn it! The current is just... Come on. There we go. Alright. Scaffolding underneath, and then we will put these away. Okay, so now our guard shack is supported. Let's take one more look at it from the front to make sure it is the height that I want. Yeah, that'll work. That'll work just fine. And the problem with this thing is I'm using up all my dirt on its placement. So maybe I need to move it. Maybe I need to move it back a little bit. Oh no. Before we do this, let's quick save. Let's quick save. Put my second stairs. Thank you, JPEG. I would have remembered when I went and tried to get up there again to look and see what the guard could see and go, oh shit, I forgot to put the stairs back in. Oh, look at him floating in the air. It just works. It just works. Okay, yeah. Yeah, he's tall enough up there. All right. Put the second. Thank you, Jay. The joys of getting old. You forget things like putting stairs back in. All right. So up we go. So the highest I can put it is this. Yeah? That's the highest I can put it. How far back will it go? Because I want as much room as possible for the... Okay, it goes back significantly further than I would have expected. Okay, how about there? If I do that, we got this. Yeah, okay, you can see the entrance down there, too. Good, okay. If I go out the front... Yeah, okay, and I've got some dirt I can use here. Good, okay. Obikabi. Because I know the fire doesn't really work. Doesn't like to work on this pier very much. Okay, so let's see what we got. Let's see what we got to work with test-wise here. Definitely all this. And then all this down here. And a little bit around the edges. So it's gonna be a little bit dicey, but I think we can do it. I think we can do it. So did we Scrappy? Roger, how you doing? Welcome to the stream. Yeah, this is pretty much the mishmash of Scrappy, dude. Like I was saying, like I was talking about in the Friday stream. It's all about asymmetry. So we've got warehouse pieces, scaffolding pieces, wood pieces, and guard pieces. So there's four different elements in this thing. And it makes it look sort of raggedy ass. Grunt Nugget, how you doing? Welcome to Grunt Nugget. I will never not laugh at your name, dude. I'm sorry, but I'm a child. That's just how I do it, right? What is my favorite? County Crossing is my favorite, Grunt Nugget. Do I have a compilation video of yours in my channel, possibly? A compilation video of, like, tours of all my favorites, or what are you asking me? Before I answer, I want to make sure I understand what you're asking me. But before I do that, we're gonna get some metal up in this bitch. Let's go ahead and do this one. Yeah. Where did I put the pillar? Is it over? Come here, pillar. Pillar, who's got the pillar? Who's got the pillar? La-dee-dee-dee-dee-dee. Like ones I have built up or finished. No, I don't really do... I mean, I do single-shot things, you know? So, I don't have a video like you're asking for, I don't think. In terms of... here's all my county crossings. Like that, you mean? Yeah, I don't have anything like that. I just put them up on the channel, and if you go to the video page, you can search the videos and just look for County Crossing. But the thing is, I don't really have, like, favorites, I guess, in the sense that most people use it. I mean, I have builds I like, builds don't like, whatever, they're fine, but I don't really leave enough room for my guards to get off the fucking dock here. Well, I could just build a little. Okay, so before I keep going on this thing, I gotta definitely have to change gears here, because I need to build them a guard barracks of some sort, so I can friggin' fence the rest of it off. So if I fence it off first, I'm gonna get screwed. So I need to build off of here. Okay, so let's try this. Let's put a scaffolding fence spacer right here. Yeah. Let's just put a scaffolding fence spacer right here. Come on. You were just right there. Okay, so there's a spacer. It's wedged into the dock pretty good. Then we're going to get a small wood floor. Because I know these things will float off the side of this. Yeah, let's do that. Okay, Now you don't float, but the stupid this thing does. Or does it? Yeah, there it goes. Where are you at, big guy? Are you close enough for my purposes? You are not. Oh, it's the tire. It's right there. I can see it down there on the left. Yeah, it's the tire. Son of a... Okay, so if I do this here... Okay, so that's pretty much where I want it to be lined up, right? Okay. So then we're going to put... I guess another one. Yeah, I have to put another one because I need to move it. Take this out. And then we'll move this closer. What? Man, why you gotta do me like this? Okay, fine. Let's see if I can't just, let's see if I can't... Why am I bothering with this? I just need floors. I don't need that thing. I just need these. So if I get these in here, I have to move that. If I do this... God, it hates me. What is under here? Is there more tires under here? No? Do I just rotate it, maybe? Will that do it? Look at that. Okay. I can live with this. It needs to be rotated just a smidgen, though. Just a tiny, tiny, tiny little bit. Okay, is that straight? Yeah, it's straight. Okay, that's straight. Now, do that. Then what we're going to do is we're going to get the marble tracks. We're going to see if I can't float this thing down just a little bit more. Limit bar. Yeah, I'm waiting to get the gamma guns until it actually says you are out of room. JPEG. I am actually waiting for it to say you have no more, so I can see what a full size bar's capacity is. That's pretty much my the method to that madness. Yeah. I'm waiting until it says you can build nothing more. It's like, all right, good. Now I know my limit. I have reached my limit. Okay. And this can snap back in. So here's the tough part. Can this... it dropped a little bit too. Nice. We'll edge it back in there. Yeah. Gonna need some more light here. Now, the tricky part. Well, I can't do it with the thing. I need to group select the whole thing at one time, man. Ain't totally not gonna work. Unless. Okay, now I gotta figure out how the hell to do this. So if I can just drop that thing just a smidgen, just a tiny little bit, I just need to drop it a tiny little bit. So how am I gonna do this? So how am I gonna. I'm edging now. Oh God, Javen. Yeah, dude, I'm edging with wooden floors. That's how I roll, man. That's what does it for me, dude. What the fuck is wrong with you, man? Oh, Jesus. Oh, man. Oh, you're killing me. You're friggin' killing me, dude. Okay. Well, let's try this. This is finally hardcore. I know, right? You guys are killing me. You're killing me. You know this, right? Cause of death? Rowdy chatters. Oh, God. Now, I wonder, will this even work? Probably not, no? Yeah, not for it to grab onto underneath. Oh, excellent, Mike. Hey, congratulations, Spoke. I kind of figured your internet's working because you're here, but congratulations. Excellent work, sir. Edging with the wood. You guys are freaking crazy, dude. Yeah, because if I put the fire here and just drop the whole thing, the fire's going to go with it, right? I mean, if I try and sink this through here to drop the whole thing, if I do this... Yeah, it's going to jump every time, right? Look at that. Okay. Sink it into a shack bridge in the water, then store it. Sink it into a shack bridge in the water. I got a lot of play under the water. I got a lot of play under the water. Well, you know what? Hang on a second. Maybe I'm overthinking this and working too hard on a solution I don't need. Because if I look over here, it's got a little lip here, too. So, okay, so that would be... Having a lip would be consistent. So, okay, I'm going to leave it alone. Trying to over-engineer a problem that it's not really a problem at this point. Okay, we're just going to leave it. We got a little lip here. It's fine. I'm working too hard on a problem that it's not really a problem. Okay. So you got that, and then this will be the guard thing. So, do that. And then go back to floors, get that big old floor out. Right. So it looks supported. Right. And we got a little traffic area there. Which is how different is edging your lawn? It makes edging your lawn turn into an entirely different kind of proposition altogether. Well, you know what? Let's just punt. This is just a guardhouse, so who gives a shit what it looks like? Let's just go ahead and... Oh, finally a use for this wall, huh? Yeah, how about that? That'll work. And then I'll put, I haven't used this one much. Let's use that one. Let's not say we did it because it won't snap because that stupid building's there. Yeah. Let's just do that. I'm running out of room on this ever-crowded deck here. Everdeck. Okay. Let's go this way, actually. Let's go over here. Okay. And then we're going to drop this bad boy right through the middle, like we do. I grabbed the wrong fire, because of course I did. Yada, yada, yada. Okay. Just need one. Don't need two. They have a really big bounding box, though, on them. Very strange. Very strange. Now, where did I put that pillar? There it is. And we're going to do the little trick that we like to do so much, which is sink this thing halfway, push it out a little bit, and call it good. Yeah, let's do that. You built a building at Jamaica? You built a building like yours with a swing on it? The non-symmetrical one? What, the one I did on Friday? You mean that weird one I built this log just as an example of how shitty buildings can be, how you can turn your normal symmetrical shit into shitty looking buildings in a very short period of time with almost no actual skill? Because I did demonstrate no actual skill on that one pretty well, I thought. Yeah, a little bit up. Come on. There. Right. Okay. And we're going to put the spire over here. And we're going to take the pillar back out of here. And then if I do... Actually, oh, you're talking. Okay, never mind. Cool. Oh, he built off that, like, that monster that you... Oh, that's sweet, dude. That's Jumanja. He said Jumanja, and I couldn't figure out which one he was referring to. It started with a J, so I went with the J. My bad. not everything's about me. And that, as it should be, Javik. Jesus, that's as it should be. Oh, God. All right. Because I assumed it was because I just built an asymmetrical building on Friday, and I'm like, okay. And I was talking about asymmetry a lot, so I'm just like, okay, I thought it was me. But my bad. Okay, so as E...
You eat.
There's my provisioner. See? She's not in the house anymore. Yeah, get out of my way. Get out the way. Move, bitch. All right. And as E has so kindly pointed out, we are at the hour and a half mark here, and I need to go ahead and stretch. I'm starting to get a little twitchy, and my brain is starting to get a little bit mushy. Well, mushier than normal. So, I'm going to go ahead and take a little intermission here. The old usual 3 to 5 minutes. Smoke them if you got them, and I'm facing the wrong way. Because I have to go third person so you can see this. Yeah? All right. And I will be right back. Right, here we go. Yes, E, please post those. Jude, how you doing, Jude? Welcome to the stream. 1, 2, 3, Big Jude! That's what's up. All right. Back in the saddle again. Completed. Help defend the slog. Look at me. I'm such a pro. I defended the slog, and I didn't do a damn thing. Of course, you all saw what that looked like on the other character, so the slog is a little overturreted. Uh-oh. JPEG's doing his own versions of songs now. Excellent. Excellent. Okay. So what have we got going now? I guess today is guard and defense day here at the old, well, that actually looks pretty damn good. Let me look at this here. Take another look at it from this angle. Yeah, we got a nice little, Visual ally 300 defense. I know, right? Yeah, so you've got two different elevated guard shacks. We're going to definitely need some turrets on the front here somewhere. I don't really know where I'm going to put them, but we're going to find out. Let's go ahead and finish up the... let's go ahead and finish up this thing here. Is that enough room to walk through here? That is not enough room to walk through here. But they're not going to need to walk through here. And that thing comes right down to the water, which is totally, totally perfect. Yeah. So what am I going to put on this? What am I going to put on this for a roof? No, I can't do that. Don't do that. That'll stick over too much. But if I sink it down into here, if I sink it down into there, that should be pretty cool. So let's do that. Let's see if I can't just drop it right into the middle of the... Let's do that so I make sure I don't lose my traffic patterns here. Okay, where do I... Here it is. There's my pillar. Now, will the metal roof actually go on the ground here? It doesn't, right? Yeah, I don't like this ground at all. Over here, maybe? No? Well, I'm gonna need a wall anyway, so let's get, a wall, a wood wall. Let me get, let's use that one. Sure, why not? Nothing more can be built. Alright, folks, time to... Go get my gamma guns, and I'm pretty sure hers are at Sanctuary. Gamma gun time! So it's time to go ahead and refill your drinks if you have not already. And we'll do that. Time to get our gamma guns. Time to find out what Egret's build budget is, yeah? They are over here. 24. I have 24 gamma guns. Booyah. Oh, and this is her supplies thing. This is her settlement. If you have not seen this, this was the school zone challenge build character, but I needed a place to put all our supplies, so I basically just fortified the carport and threw all our crap in here. So this is what her home, her personal house looks like. It's just and yeah, Carla's got a chair that she never uses, but it's just, you know, I gated off the driveway and then put the cooking station there and put all the stuff underneath, and that's pretty much it. Didn't really do much with this at all. This is your absolute crude but functional sort of build there. Yeah. Okay. I'm eager tours. Let's go. I didn't build down by the bridge. Well, no. This is normal. This ain't survival, dude. So fast travel mass right by the yellow house. All the stuff was already up there, so I was like, well, shit. I mean, the yellow house already has... My fast travel spot needs to be moved, clearly. Let's do that. Let's move the fast travel spot, shall we? Yeah. But yeah, when I'm building in vanilla, I mean, whatever, I'll just build it by the yellow house because it's already got three of the workstations I need, so it's like, well, why not? Yeah. Okay, I have a fast travel net. I should be able to put the fast travel net down, right? No, I can't even put the fast travel net down. Okay, well, let's fix that in a minute. Where is the workbench? Okay, the workbench is in here. So I'll just drop them out here. We'll just do them out here. That'll be fine. Dun, dun, dun. Okay, so here comes the boring part, folks. La-di-da. As I drop guns one at a time. The nice thing about gamma guns is they're small, so they tend to drop in a pretty tight arc right around my feet. Unlike when you drop boards or sledgehammers or assault rifles. They kind of go flying all over the place because they're so big. Da-da-da. Gail, how you doing? Welcome to the stream. You have come at a good time. We are doing exciting administrative work, which is dropping gamma guns on the ground. 1, 2, 3, 4, 5. Then we go 1001, 1002. Okay. And there they are. There's my boys. All glowing. Okay. Let's start putting these away. 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8, 9, 10, 11, 11, 12, 13, 14, 15, 16, 17, 18, 19, 20, 1, 22, 23, and 24. So what's that, about two-thirds of the size bar? So we got 36. Looks like 36 again for this one. Okay. I gotta take all that crap out of here. No, I don't, because there's nobody here. 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8. The good thing is you don't have to do this very often, you know? Normally with my builds, I only got to do it once, right? 1001, 1002. MB Proxy, how you doing? Welcome to the stream. You've come at an exciting time. We are storing gamma guns. It's very exciting. 25, 26, 27, 28, 29, 30, 31, 32, 33, 34, 5, 36, 37, 38, 39. So, okay, so 39 gamma guns, guys. So, Egret has a pretty generous budget. It's up there. It is up there. It is definitely up there. Give me these back. Thank you. Dun, 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 dun. So yeah, 39 gamma guns to reset Egret. So it's on par with Starlight in terms of its just waiting the 2 seconds after dropping and prevent them from flying around. Anecdotally, yes. And I ever since I had a point where I dropped a whole bunch of shit. And it just dropped straight to the ground, stayed there. I had it in my head that just waiting 2 seconds, just do it. Just do it. But I don't know if it's a fact or not. I just know it works for me, and I know it makes me feel better to do it. It might just be a friggin' placebo. I don't know. There's no guaranteed yes, this is why, you know? Let's put it that way. It worked for me a couple of times, so I just kept doing it. And you know me, man. When I find something that works, I'm like, fuck it, I'm sticking with it. Okay, let's build this in scrap, because I'm not going to need that one. And we'll take this out. Okay, and my pillar, I left way the hell over here. So yeah, it might just be a placebo. Straight up a placebo. I can't point to any factual... Yes, it works like this and because and blah. It's just like, okay, it seems to work, so I kept doing it, and it continues to work, so I don't know. Alright. Okay, good. We have some good elevation here. And down. And turn a little bit this way to line it up. Yeah. Now I'm gonna need marble tracks for this one, aren't I? Okay. There you go. Put you back over here so I don't lose you. It's all random, dude. You know this. Come on. Dalton, that's how we do, man. You never know. It's like a box of chocolates, man. You never know what you're going to get. Well, you know you're going to get fallout. You're going to get a lot of faffing about. You're going to get about a lot of double entendres and a lot of juvenile raging and a lot of juvenile shenanigans in the chat. But other than that, yeah, it's pretty much crapshoot, man. Okay. And... Now, how much of this can I It's got to be closer. Damn it! Damn it, it's got to be closer. It's got to be closer. It's got to be closer. It's going to be this way. Like here. Now you want to listen to Smash. Well, nobody's stopping you, Groucho. Knock yourself out, man. Have a good old time with that. Have a good old time with that. As I struggle to put in this roof piece for the last 15 minutes. Okay. Okay, there it is. Hold up a little bit more, come on. And then down. Okay, what is it not liking here? Is it not liking that second? Well, that's okay, that, because the metal part of it, well, I guess I'll just put it right here and see what happens, yeah? Sure. Let's just put it right there and see what happens. How is that? Oh, it goes through. It looks like crap. Perfect. That's what I wanted. That is what I wanted. That's the one that I want. It is the one I want. Ooh. Ooh, honey. Okay. Now that that's there, when the stream is done. Well, you can do both at the same time, baby. And Mikey, yes, I'm definitely going to try and stop by later on. I've got some stuff I got to do. Hopefully I can make it. I'm going to make the attempt. And someone asked me something that just rolled off. I think it was MB Proxy. If you don't mind repeating that, dude, I would be happy to answer whatever it was. Because when chat goes tonight, when chat goes too fast, I lose things and I hate it. But it's part of what you get when you're so popular. Oh, God. I mean, technically it's true, but it makes me feel weird saying that. Okay. Now, will this... Don't even show where you farm all your junk and a video will go to detail my supply line. If you want to know about supply lines, methods in, no. Settlements and survival. Guys, it's 16, right? 16's got the provisional breakdown. Why I do depots, how I do things in survival. I'm pretty sure it's settlements and survival 16 for the provisioner thing. How I farm all my junk? Dude, okay. How I farm all my junk, dude, is a brute force method. When you see me do a gameplay video, right? When I do a let's play or whatever, I'm playing, right? You'll see that I level like crazy, and all I do is I go and kill shit, right? After the stream, okay, after the stream off camera, what I will do is I will write down all the locations I went to, and then I go back to those locations, dude, and I strip them bare. I locust the crap out of them. I will sit here for an hour just drinking and looting shit. Fast travel back and forth and just strip fucking everything. I don't care. So the looting thing is just just time consuming. It's a time consuming process. That's just Discord will be open so I can hop in. Okay. Thank you very much, Mikey. I don't, after a stream, I generally don't speak a word to a human being for the rest of the day. I can type and stuff. But, yeah, so I will join you in chat for sure if I am able. And y'all, just to make sure that if you're not aware of it already, what we're talking about is Mikey streams Fallout 4 building modded. I'm almost positive on Sundays at I'm gonna say, is it 8 Eastern, Mikey? I always forget. I get so screwed up with the time zones, dude, because my brain is so cooked after a stream. I always forget. But if you click his name, click the three dots next to his name, you can get a link to his channel where you can join us all later on in approximately 5 hours after this stream. If I haven't that wrong, Mikey, which you probably do, please feel free to drop plenty of corrections in the chat so everyone can participate. And you can join in the craziness there as well, because we do the same damn shit there as we do here. Except Mikey's way cooler than me, so his streams are much more interesting. 7:30 Eastern. Okay, so 7:30 Eastern, 6:30 Central. 6:30 Central? Oh my god. I may be coming late today. 6:30 Central, 5:30 Mountain, and 4:30 Pacific time. Look at me, I'm a time zone maven. Oh, I like this. Oh, I like that. Look at that texturing, baby. Wow. Okay, I need to cover the bottom of those boards, though. I definitely need to cover the bottom of those boards. Okay, so like that. Yeah. Oh, look at that. The posts actually line up, too. Isn't that nice? Yeah, we'll go like... we'll go like that. There's no way I'm getting that rug back, though. There's no way I'm getting that rug back. But let's see if we can. You never know. And request denied. Okay. So that... There's your fortified backstop, metal wall, texturing, blah, 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 blah. I go into power conservation mode. Crimson Imperial Taurus, how you doing? Welcome to the stream. If you're new to the stream, dude, I've gone over this before, but I don't mind, you know, as you know, I don't mind repeating myself. I am on the sort of moderate to extreme end of the introversion scale. And being on like this, performing, which is what this basically is, for 3 hours wipes me out in a way that few things do. A lot of the times after the stream, I will literally just take a nap. I'm so wiped out. So I have to limit my human interaction after that point, and that's not going to work. So it's just a thing. You learn to live with it. It's not a bad thing. It's something I have to be cognizant of. So I don't really make interactive promises on Sundays after the streams, because I mean it literally wipes me the fuck out. And yeah, we'll do that one. Give a little visual variety. So, how did I manage to get past to do my first stream video? I can do it. I can manage this type of stuff. I just have to prepare for it, Gail. If you think of it like a battery, if I get my battery charged up and I know I'm going to be expending the energy, I can just go ahead and limit my human interaction before that, which sounds really terrible when I say it like that. But it's just something you learn to manage. It's not the end of the world. It's not, you know, whatever. It is what it is. And do I have any more fences in here? No. Okay, so I'll put... but yeah, it's just a management thing, you know. And I'm fortunate that my... boss at work is aware of this, so that when I have to go to a lot of meetings consecutively, he knows I'm going to need like a half hour. I just go into the conference room and just sit and close my eyes. So, does it work scrapping armor or just guns? The size bar thing. Let me get back to that MB proxy. Let me finish with Gale. But yeah, my first stream video. If you watch my first video, that was my scapper playthrough, and I basically didn't say anything for the first like 10 minutes. I couldn't figure out what to do. It just takes practice, like anything else. And you get used to it after a fashion. But it's just something that I have to actively manage. Thankfully, it's easier to do now because I've gotten used to it. I've gotten more practice at it and stuff. But it can still be challenging from time to time. Now, does it work scrapping armor, just guns? It works storing anything. Any item you drop on the ground. Don't scrap them, though, dude. Don't scrap them. Store them, because that way you can use them over and over and over. Why will you not snap there? Piece of shit. Because of that? Look at this stupid thing. It'll snap here, and it'll snap down here, but it won't snap here. But now if I take the wall, it'll snap. Build order. But yeah, you don't want to, let me get back to one. Let me distract myself. You don't want to scrap them, because that way you're going to use them once. You store them. And how it works is it goes by the complexity of the object. Yeah? The complexity of the object. So you want something that has a very visually complicated model like this one does. I mean, it's got arcs, it's got dishes, it's got those little capacitors on the back. It's got a lot of round and intricate detail on it. Okay? And it goes by what's called triangles, polygons. Yeah. This thing here, its base model has like 14,000 polys. Right? It has twice as many polygons as the cooling tower across the street from County Crossing. It is incredibly visually complex. So the gamma gun works best for doing that trick with the size bar, because it eats a lot of the size bar for every single one. You don't have to do so many, you know. They take the biggest chunk out of the build limit. Exactly what he said. Now, heavily modded weapons can also do this, but they're kind of a pain in the ass because it's random. Gamma guns, you know where they come from. Any children in them you kill in the Commonwealth is going to have one. So you just go to, you farm them when you hear them fighting gunners, you wait, you get three there. You get five or six at the crater house. And you get, you can go to the glowing sea and pickpocket those. But, you know, it's a thing. So, yeah. Modified handmade rifles. Yeah, see, anything that's visually complex will do it. It's just, gamma guns are easy because they're light, they're consistent. You can get them, you know where you can get them. And getting a lot of them is just a matter of time. So, but yeah, anything will work. Okay, now what am I doing here? We've got that thing there, so I'm just going to need another, junk wall right there, I think. Okay, so there's that. Yeah. Yeah, for gamma guns, it's the size, it's the combination of size, convenience, easy access, and weight. Because they only weigh 3 pounds apiece. So I can carry a ton of them on me and not be overburdened. Heavily modded guns will sometimes weigh in the 20-pound range, so you carry 15 of those around, and you're, you know, walking slow or whatever. And going, the doing the talking thing, it just takes practice, Gale. It just takes practice. What helps, if you want some advice, it helps if you pretend that you have your best friend sitting in the chair next to you, and you're just shooting the shit while you're building, because that's pretty much what we're doing here, you know? I'm just basically shooting the shit while I put things up. With y'all, you know, and I will say it does take some practice being able to talk while you're concentrating on being able to do stuff while you're talking, because even now you'll see when I'm answering your questions complicated, I'll stop because I can't concentrate on two things at once, or it's too difficult to concentrate on two things at once. But thankfully building has become second nature to the point where unless I'm describing what I'm doing, I really have to think about what I'm doing because it's instinctive, because that's how I build. So. You actually went to listen to my first stream like a week ago. Yeah, the one with the weird thumbnail where she's crouched in the Rad Storm or whatever. Yeah, I didn't even know how to make thumbnails on streams, dude. I was completely... Oh, no, don't do that. Damn it. It's going to pick up everything now, isn't it? No? Good. Okay, down you go. Okay, big fella. With your wall-colored yellow. You trying to prove, because that's my woman there, and I'm a man who cares, and this might be all for you. I said excuse me. Oh, also Gail, another tip, and for anybody who wants to do this or wants to think is thinking about streaming, as weird as this sounds, your best asset is acting like a complete idiot. Just saying whatever comes to mind, man. Because people come here for your personality, you know? So give them one. Be dumb. Say stupid shit. It works for me. But the key is just practice and relaxing. But pretending like you're talking to somebody that's in the room with you helps a ton. Because, I mean, I'm sure you've had friends over when you're playing games. You just sit around and just shoot the shit while you, you know, kill stuff or whatever it is you do. And it's like, it's the same thing. It's just the people are on the chat window instead of in the chair next to you. Okay. That's that. And that's blocked off there. Does it look stupid in the water? It hangs off a little bit, but that's not too terrible. That's actually pretty good. So, okay. So then this, you know what? No, I don't want, damn it. I don't want this to be blocked off. I think we're going to go for something a little bit different here. Come on, right there. Damn it. Jesus, where? There. Right, enemy missiles at the pace of level 10. Yeah, the immersive gameplay. Yeah, that was those were. Yeah, I'm sure they were entertaining for y'all, but for me, I was like, oh Jesus, never again. It's just you just got, like I said, you just got to wing it, and the hardest part is not worrying about how you sound, you know, and getting used to the sound of your own voice. That one there is just something you need to learn how to do, and that just comes from, that ain't gonna work, is it? That comes from practice and repetition. After the first two or three streams I did, I was very self-conscious about it. But what helped, and this is gonna sound really self-centered and egotistical, guys, I'm gonna go ahead and apologize in advance. But what helped is turning on your own stream while you're doing something else and just listening to it. Right? Just listening to it. Because what will happen is, after a couple of hours, it'll be the voice on the TV or the voice out of the phone. It won't be my voice. And that sounds like a weird distinction. I'm going to go ahead and own that. But it's to the point now where when I listen to my own streams, when I listen to them back, I don't think of that voice as me. I think of that as the guy who's streaming, which sounds a little bit psychotic. But that detachment will help you get over the self-consciousness of oh my God, I sound like shit. Well, everybody's got their own voice, and there's nothing you can do about it, so you might as well just learn to live with it. That's just how it is. So, John, how you doing? Welcome to the stream. Tried that as the beginning of the opening takes out of that place. Yeah, it's, like I said, it's just you have to, it's just practice, man. Like anything else, it's practice. It's absolutely practice. And, but it doesn't, if you devote yourself to it, if you concentrate on it and focus on it, it doesn't really take that long to master. You get used to it really quickly. Okay, you get used to it really quick. And once you get used to it, it's all downhill from there. But it's just overcoming that first initial, oh my God, I sound like a freaking idiot. Who's going to listen to this bullshit? There are people that will listen to it. You just got to get out there and gut up and say, you know what? Fuck it. I'm just going to do this. I'm going to do it because I love it. And if people like it, great. And if not, well, I'm still going to do it because I love it. It's fun. I get you, Jax. Don't worry, man. We don't worry about typos here, man. We are very low-key on the typo train, my friend. Because people are on phones. They got autocorrect. Not everybody's got English as a first language or even a second language sometimes. So as long as we can get what you're saying, we're fine. And if we can't, we will ask. So it's all good, man. It is all good. We are low maintenance, low pressure, low key. Okay, is that straight? That's pretty straight. Because what I want to do is snap. I want to snap fest it down the dock. And I don't want to have to sit here and dick with us all day. But I need to be high enough to where it's going to... Come on. Okay. Is that going to be sufficient for my porpoises? Come on. Okay, so it doesn't want to snap there. Will this snap? Okay, that snaps. Come on. And then we'll snap this here. That's a little bit crooked. God. Yeah, but that's okay. Maybe I can get this to snap now. Okay. Ah! Ah! There it was. Yeah, I'm just going to punt and just put a rail fence on here to hold it. And can I get out here? Yeah, I can get out here. But that's okay. Okay. That's good enough. Good enough. We're just going to put a friggin' wire fence up here so they can have a party on the patio or what have you. The walling's begun. Your picture of one naked? That would be way too distracting for me, son. I would be all... Wow, those are nice. Oh, my goodness, I had no idea that was that big. But then having a vivid imagination can be a downside. the TWSS things would just go off the chain, man. No, that's not the best idea for me, I don't think. Yeah, no. Oh, Lord have mercy. Okay, so we got the guard here. Okay, let's see what it looks like now. Let's go ahead and evaluate. Yeah, you know what? Keeping it open makes it look pretty good on the underside there. Winning in a face reveal for me. Winning in a face reveal. I'll do the face reveal on the same stream that we'd start using Place Anywhere. JPEG. How about that? The answer is probably never. Probably never, JPEG. That is not something that I am entirely comfortable with. Given that I have a very long history on the internet, and I wish to avoid having my name associated with my face, or even my handle, it's not... it's something that makes me, even to this day, makes me, even thinking about it makes me go, ah. Like, no, that's not a thing. And that's not the kind of YouTuber I want to be, you know? I don't want this to be about me, I want this to be about the builds. I am just an accessory to the activity that is occurring. Yeah, see, now that square building looks good, because we've got some visual variety clogging it up, right? No worries, but the thing is, JP, a lot of people ask, you know, so I want to make sure that I'm not doing it because I'm being arbitrary. There's actual reasons, and you can only see this from this angle, right? You can only see that from that angle, and from this angle, that you can see it's not that it's floating. Can I live with that? I don't need to support that, right? If I go under here, Jesus, this thing got twisty too. Hey, Kevin, thank you. Kevin, if you're watching this later, thank you for putting the twisty building shit in my head, because it's fun, but it's hard to get around your settlement sometimes. It looks good. Yeah, okay, it looks good? All right, well, I will take Fergie's word for it. I will be glad to, I'll be glad to take the advice of people who agree with me. That sounds reasonable, yeah? And then if you look at it from this side, yeah, I don't like shit from this side. But that looks decent. That's not terrible. It's a little open. Now, because I'm wondering, so here's the question, so I'm trying to figure this shit out, right? The shack foundation is here. You can see the green outline of it, right? But if you look at this piece, its floorboards are exposed. So the surface of this, the bottom of this, is higher than this. Which means, if I am correct, I should be able to snap one of those half walls to this exposed corner piece. Right? This should snap. And it does not. Does it not snap because of this? Or is it not snapping because it's not on the wall? Yeah! Okay. So it does snap when you use the fire trick, as long as you elevate it sufficiently. But this thing will block it. So build order again for the win. Okay. Alright, Dalton. Thanks for stopping by, man. Good to see you as always, sir. Enjoy your lunch. And hopefully there will be food and not just liquor involved in your lunches. But either way, enjoy. So this thing's here now. Good. We got that. Let's get these other tools out of the way here. Move them back out and get them away from the back of this, which is now completed, pretty much. I'm going to have to fill in this thing somehow with something. I don't know what this is going to be, though. Because this is the guardhouse, the main guard shack, and this is... I could sleep two in here, or just one. Or two. Put them head-to-head. Let's do that now. Let's just do that now. Give them a plain rug. Yeah. Give them a plain old rug. No, put two beds in here, head-to-head. No, I need beds, dude. Beds. Yeah. Cot. Do that one here. Ooh, it doesn't like that interior pole, does it? Okay. Do that here. And then we'll do the other one over here. So even if they were using these beds, they could still get to them. Yeah. Right. And then in the corner we will put shop, Roger. Could you expand on that a bit? I don't know what your inquiry is referring to. I put a TV in there. That'd be funny. I'll put a toilet in there too. Make them go for broke. Huh? Oh, well, these might work really well. What else we got in here? Ah. Aha. Yeah. See, I put a shelf down, but to decorate it. So maybe we'll put that in there. Put a dispenser on the floor. I think I need to have their yogurt here, right? Nothing in there I want. Containers? Yeah, see, if I put this in there, which will fit, well, maybe it won't. Yeah, you wouldn't be able to open the drawers. What should go? Probably just a table. I guess I gotta just punt and put a table in this thing, right? Yeah, put that in there. This one? Yeah, that'll work. Where's the drawer? There's the drawer. Yeah, I'll just put that in there. That's fine. That's fine. Inside the building. This one here? Oh, here. This thing here. Well, that's the thing, Roger. If you look at how I built this thing, the only people who can get back here are the actual guards, right? Because the only way into it, if you look over here, let's look at the traffic patterns again, yeah? So anyone coming down here is going to see that monstrosity, right? They're going to have a guard looking at them from up there with a turret, and they got this thing here. There's no way into this section from this side other than jumping over this railing, right? So to get in there, you have to go down here, go past the old promenade, whatever the hell this is going to be, past the bar, take a left, go across this bridge, then go through the back here, past the stairs, and then bang, now you're in this little courtyard. So this is the only way you can be accessible from this little courtyard. Bree Pizza, what's up? Welcome to the stream. So this is going to be the guards area. So what's probably going to happen here is this is going to be, I'm going to put a workbench back here. Yeah. Put a workbench back here. Get rid of these terminals. I don't need these things anymore. Yeah. And I'll just make this the guards, their relaxation area, I guess. Put a workbench, put some tables in here, you know, or whatever. Or wall it all off, or I don't even know what, but it's a place where they'll do their maintenance. And maybe I'll put the armor workbench out here. Yeah. Put it on the deck. Sink some metal into this bad boy. Maybe do that. Sink some metal into this thing, and no, I'm not gonna need that. I just need the pillar. I just need the pillar. Let's do that. Let's do that. Now that you got me thinking about it, let's go ahead and explore the possibilities. Now, I know I got a ton of those friggin' metal floors and concrete. Yeah. I got an ass load of these things. So, if we do one here, right? Let's say we make the armor workbench. We're gonna put the armor workbench right next to this station. Yeah? Let's do this. Yeah? Yeah. Well, we gotta line it up first, though. So it looks cool. It's gotta look cool, man. It's gotta look cool. So we line it up on the floorboards, the deck there. Right? And then we do this. Put that there. Take these out. No, not that one. This one. Get it away from there so I group selected. It won't pick everything else in the world up. Drop this muffin right here down a little bit into the deck so it looks like it's seated, and now it'll snap, yeah? But it won't snap here because of that trash, probably. You piece of shit. Why you gotta be like that, man? Okay. So I know this thing snaps. So let's take that out so I don't get any group select shenanigans here. And put it up a little bit, snap that in there. Oh shit, now it's too close to the other one, isn't it? Damn it. No, it's not too close to the other one. And now it'll sink. Look at that. Look at that. Okay, is that going to be big enough for an armor workbench, though? Oh yeah, it'll be fine. Look at that. Okay, perfect. So let's go ahead and sink that down there. Yeah? Go ahead and just push it down a little bit. Yeah, right there. A little bit more, a little bit more, and right there. So it has a little bit of trash coming out, but not too much. Yeah? Perfect. Then we'll put that wire fence back in. Where is it? It better go back in. That's all I gotta say. I'll be very unhappy if it does not go back in. Ah! Duh. No, I went the other way. Just like that. So now my armor workbench here. Okay. So we're gonna do concrete, sure. Put some railings up around this thing, make it look kind of cool, right? Make it look like they're Oh, it won't snap to that one though. Huh, interesting. Well, that's fine. I'll just leave those two there. That'll be cool. It'll be there so they don't walk into the railing. Yeah? No. Not stores. Crafting. This one. Okay, so now I got an armor workbench. On the metal, like I like it. The little protective fence so they don't walk into it when they're trying to use it. Just can move it over a little more this way. Well, maybe I can't because that railing's in the way. But that's okay. That's okay. Yeah. Okay, so that's their armor workbench. Build order shenanigans. Oh, that's pretty cool, dude. That is pretty cool. I never really thought about that myself. I don't... Of course, I'm not getting enough sleep. That is always a factor as well, Groucho. I will... I am definitely on page, I can't get enough sleep. I don't get enough sleep. Oh, the scaffolding snaps there. That's kind of good. That'll be fine. They can just work on it in the outdoors because whatever, it's an armor workbench, eh? And then, what else are we going to do with this? I really want to move it over to the left some more, but it doesn't like to do that. So I guess I'm going to have to, rug this bad boy. Rug this bad boy. It's gonna have to be this one though, because it's too close to anything else. And yes, I know it's. I just realized it's getting dark, guys. So hold on one sec. Just let me place this thing, and then we'll get daylight back. And up. Yep. Thank you. Okay. I'm gonna put you here. And I can't see the other legs because it's too dark for me to see because I'm not the sharpest knife in the drawer. And voila. Let's turn the light on. Duh. That's not terrible. Need to pull it back a little bit though. Yeah, that's good. And that way I can put this on there. Where is my toolbox? There she is, right there. And voila. Okay. Well, let's go jump over the wall. Get ourselves a little bit of daylight. Daylight. Put my ad up, la dee 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 da. You don't know anyone, just inserted myself in. That's how you do it, John. That's how you do it. Just drop in and start making noise, man. That's how we roll here. We have a very welcoming community with a very high tolerance level for what most people would consider unacceptable shenanigans. And our lack, yeah. See, look at that. Look how, look at this. It's times like this, I look at this, I'm like, what am I even doing? I mean, look at this crazy shit, dude. This is what, 9 hours? A building? Something like that? Got our little protected little platform here. Very, he liked the sub as soon as you joined. Well, thanks, man. Thank you very much. I hope you don't regret that decision. And if you do, you can always change it, right? You can always change it. Okay, so coming out of the water, let's see what we got here water-wise. So our waterway goes down here, and there's nothing here, and there's no way out of here. Yeah? And honestly, that floating bit doesn't look too bad because you can barely even see it. I'm totally going to stress on this until I stop thinking about it, just so you know. Now, being able to get out here Definite problem. Definite problem. But we will figure that out at some future date. These have not respawned. Excellent. Let's go up here, see what we got. Yeah, see, now the main building that I was bitching that was so symmetrical and it looked like shit because it was flat on the back, now it looks normal because now you can't tell. Because even from this vision, even from this view angle, there's so much other shit cluttering it up that, you know, I might just stick with just this for the settlement, guys. I'm happy with just this. I don't really need much more than this. And you got this thing here. Well, you know what? Let's go ahead and not preemptively. Let's not preemptively shut this off. But this, I'm telling you guys, this thing right here is feeling really complete right now. Just what we got here is really feeling done. In terms of what it needs to be its own little functional outposty settlement. Now, of course, I'd have to punt and fix that ladder on the roof for sure to get some way for them to get some way. What I'm doing right now is I'm looking at every part of the scene trying to figure out what's missing. Sorry guys, I'm not talking because I'm running over options in my head right now as I look at this thing. Cause it's feeling both complete and not complete, and I cannot quite figure out why. I don't know where the sticking point is. It's like why is this not feeling done? And yet why is it feeling done at the same time? Because this, okay, so you got the entrance to the bar, yeah, blah. Put some seats there, put the bartender guy here, make this his pathway back to whatever his bed's going to be or where his housing is going to be. I guess I got to put some housing on top of the, I'm going to look at this light again. That's just so fucking cool. Such a happy accident. There's your happy accident for the day, yeah? There's your happy accident. Tyler, how you doing? Welcome to the stream, sir. Sorry I missed you coming in. Okay, so what we need here then, all right, so we've got the bit in our teeth on guard stations today, apparently, because this is what we built, right? We built this thing up here and this mess down here, which is a guard station. So we're gonna need a guard station down there, particularly since we really need it because shit spawns on that bridge. Yeah. Optimus Narkil, how you doing? Welcome to the stream. Good day to you. Is that a good day coming in or a good day going out? Either way, good day to you. How's the guard going to get up on that post that's Lumber's Lombard? I have not figured that out yet. This one here, where I'm at now, guard? Yeah. That's part of the, I don't know where we're going with this. What I may... You know... Groucho. You have given me an idea, sir. You have given me an idea. Another patch the thing that needs to be patched. Okay, let's move all our tools. Let's get all our tools back into our working area because it's very important that we have all our tools. Even those comes like a penis with the two fires on the side and whatever. It's phallic and okay, sure, whatever. Fine. You know what? Let's put them in here. Because I'm going to need the working area outside. You were wondering about making the roof another platform. Okay, hang on a second, guys. The chat is going really fast. Jack says, I don't know, 6 feet. Oh, you came from the Tuesday collab. Ah, okay. Made you want to build in Fallout 4 again? Well, nice, dude. Excellent! Always good to have more builders on the scene, man. I'm glad this stuff was useful. That's my favorite saying. I am glad that someone actually found this useful enough to motivate them to contribute and participate in the community. the roof and other platform. Yeah, I don't know what I'm going to do with the roof and other platform part, but we're going to see what's possible here. Okay, so clearly, rinka rinka, ooh baby, take my concrete pillar and take it deep. So, okay, we can do really good things with this. You know what? What's the look inside? Oh yeah, man, look at that. Stab it right to the ceiling, baby. Stab it right to the ceiling. Ugh. They like it deep. Now, what can we do with the marble pillar? Can this go? Holy shnikes! I bet you that goes all the way almost to the floor, doesn't it? Let's just jam shit through the roof. This is fun. Whee! You gotta go. All right, free pizza. Thanks for stopping by, man. Hope to see you again soon. Soon-ish. Chain. All right. It's okay, Groucho. What I need is I need to wait for the guard to get up to this top part, yes? But we also need a guard station looking over this bridge. And I don't necessarily want to build in that corner. So, what we can do is, now, here's the question. Is this roof nav meshed? Yes, this roof is nav meshed. We know this roof is nav meshed because the fucking provisioner sits on here all the fucking time. We absolutely know that this is nav meshed. So, I don't actually have to build anything up here for the guards to be able to walk around up here. Right? All I gotta do is build a friggin' guard station. I can just jam it to the roof with the friggin'... I can just do, like... Let's say I want a guard station, like, here. Yeah? Let's just put it right here, because it's kind of close to the bridge, right? You can see it from there. It's near the build border, blah, 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 right? Let's see what's possible. Let's play around with this. Time to experiment. I need defense. What the hell am I doing? Okay. Ha! Sink that to the roof. That'd be fucking hilarious. Okay. Let's take this, right? And let's just take this. Let's just see what we can do with this thing, yeah? If the ground cooperates, which it randomly does or does not, yeah? Turrets. I'm not gonna add a lot of turrets here, man. I'm not gonna add a lot of turrets here. This is gonna be a very low-key, low-maintenance kind of settlement. So we can just hang this bastard right off the... Okay, so what will it let me get away with in terms of this particular object? Okay. So the guard station. Is finicky as hell. Wow. Okay. This thing is finicky as hell. That may be a problem. Okay, let's pull it back a little bit. I'm thinking like when I sing random songs, I'm just randomly humming shit. Yeah, it's... Well, I have a very odd... Okay, something's wrong here. Because that should be working... Okay, what is under this? There's nothing underneath it, really. Where is it at? Okay, so it's right here, right? It's on this level. It's right there. It's about half a car length there. So is it hitting the shelves? Is it hitting the rafters? I bet it's hitting the rafters, huh? Okay, well, there's only one way to find out, huh? Let's experiment, kids! That's what we like to do. Okay, so it doesn't go here, right? But it will go... Jesus, where will it go? Okay. Let's back up a little bit here. Okay, so we got no action there. We have no action anywhere in this corner, pretty much. Okay, something's wrong with that. Maybe over here? Okay, so we got good action there. Maybe it's just this corner piece, yeah? Leathers because it has an edge on it or something? Maybe it's the same here. Yeah, that's definitely. It, maybe it's just a different roof piece. Because you look at the, you can see that this roof piece here has a dimple in it, right? It's bent. So it's definitely a different static, as is this one. These are all rumply, right? But this one is flat. So let's test our theory. If it works, then this won't sink. But it does. This game fucking hates me, man. But if I put it up here, it absolutely hates this. So this corner piece, whatever reason, this piece right here is a pain in the ass. Okay, keep that in mind, folks. If you're built up here, you're gonna try this. The corner piece by the front is a pain in the ass. So if I do this now, let's go ahead and Well, see, the thing is, John, I like to know how things work so I know how to abuse them. Yeah. And if I can find peculiarities that have a consistent theme, I can make better predictions on when I want to build something somewhere else. That's really the whole point of this, is to see what the fuck I can get away with. How often, where, and with which tools. But I mean, if I really wanted to, I could figure out why right now, dude. I could just straight up go into CK, just drop in here, pop Egret Tours, look at that piece, and see how the hell it's made. Which is an interesting peculiar. Okay, here we go. Yeah. And down. Oh, that guard station doesn't like touching anything. Anything. It doesn't do anything. Oh, that is completely. Well, tell you what, let's try this. Let's put it here. Let's just experiment with this a little bit, because my brain's getting a little bit cooked. I think I got overstimulated today. A little overstimulated. Now, we know, thanks to JPEG, I'm going to keep giving him credit for this knowledge. We know that, okay, so it won't snap to this. It won't snap through a roof. Okay, that's fair. That's absolutely fair. From the bottom, looks like that. But I can patch that with stuff. That's not a thing. Rugged? Ooh. Maybe. I generally don't rug, just so you know, John, I generally don't rug these guard posts. I don't immediately reach for that. Because for whatever reason, for me, guard posts behave very strangely when I remove the rug. Inconsistently, that's the word I'm looking for. Inconsistently. Sometimes they jump, sometimes they don't. Sometimes they hop, sometimes they don't. Sometimes they fall, sometimes they don't. I've never been able to adequately explain or predict which is going to be based on what I'm doing with them. So, but yeah, basically all I want to do is build a little guard shack up on top of the thing there. And come on, baby, up you go. Come on. Okay. Now if I do this, the rug's gonna go through the roof, yeah? If I do it the way I want it. Okay, so let's do this. See if I can't figure this out. Down you go. In you come. Okay, so there are that's the front of it, where those posts are. Yeah? No. Needs to go a little bit further out. Right about there. Yeah? Okay, up you come. And we're going to drop it to where it's just underneath the surface like that. Yeah. Okay, so that's good. I can live. Let me get up here. Yeah, I can live with that. With that placement right there. Just sitting up there by itself like that. I don't really care. Now, oh shit. Let's quick save. Let's quick save. Now the fun part. What will happen when I pull this rug out? It dropped. But it did not drop very much. Did it drop? Yeah, it dropped too far. It dropped too far. Shit. Let's go ahead and load this back up. You don't remove the rugs. Yeah. I do, John, because I don't like to waste my build budget on rugs, even though it's only like four tries, but whatever. I got a million budget, and I don't even like to waste four, because it's like, Okay, so it's there. If I get up on this thing and get it at a higher angle, will I do something different? that still drops. And that's just, that's too much hanging through there. That's too much hanging through there. I don't like it. No, sir. I don't like it. What's the level cap in FO4? 275? Someone correct me if I'm wrong, but I'm almost positive it's 275. Because that's when the experience point total bangs up against the end cap. The 2 billion. I'm pretty sure it's 275. But I have been wrong before, and I definitely will be wrong again. And I'm not feeling this particular thing right here. This is the right idea, but it's the wrong application. It's not going... I need to build a framework up here. You gonna take a break? All right, Jude. Thanks for stopping by. Always good to see ya. Always, always good to see you. Okay, so let's try some build order shenanigans then. Shall we? Let's. Okay. So if I do this, I'm gonna float it on the roof line, right? So if I wanna do that, watch, it's gonna pick up the... No, it didn't pick up the guard station. Nice. Okay. Okay, where did I put the marble there? Okay. So if I do this, I know what am I doing? I'm doing it all wrong. Wah. The actual cap is over 1,000. Well, all right. Do they have any actual like proof of this, or is this just something they were saying, John? I have my reasons to somewhat distrust or at least be suspicious of unsourced claims. Okay, there's that. Barn loft pieces that have built-in supports. Barn loft pieces that have built-in supports? Barn pieces... Like these? Nixo, is this what you're talking about? Or... I don't know what you're referring to. Are you talking to somebody else? Probably already talking to somebody else. That'd be my guess. Okay, so the end of the stream here, this part's gonna be experimentation. To see what we can get away with on this roof, and to see what happens with very okay, the roof pieces. Oh, I see what you're saying. The roof pieces with the supports, the ones with the little wooden railing things inside them. Okay, so we got that. We got this. Is that straight? Straight enough. Okay. 65, 535. Oh, okay. Okay. Alright, that makes sense. That makes sense. Thank you very much. Thank you very much. So we get that here. Floors in here? No, I don't. So I'll just use these for spacers. Okay, so I cannot snap another one to this. That is good information. But do that. Not quite. Have I considered assembling the guard shack with floor pieces and glitching them together? Yes. Yes, I have, JPEG. What I'm doing right now is testing how those floor pieces are going to work and testing how they sink through. Basically, I'm test fitting it, trying to figure out what's happening with this part of it right now. And then once I figure this part out, I'll go somewhere else, build the damn thing, because I know that this will work. You know what I mean? Put a scaffolding floor snap there. Not to these pieces. It'll probably... Oh, scaffolding floor. Let's find out. I'm gonna guess no. Because it's the fence. It's not the snapping that's the problem. It's this roof. I need to glitch it in to get it in that roof. I do like this approach thing. And but yeah, that's what I'm sort of doing, JP. That's the prologue to that sort of thing. And in fact, I mean, if we could just keep building, right? Well, scaffolding floors, I can just go wood floors. I can do that here. I do it on the other side, because I know this corner piece is kind of funky, right? So will it snap here? No, it won't. Okay, so it just hates that roof line, which is fair. So I can build two square floors out, no problem. And then I could use... watch, this roof angle is going to be the wrong one, right? It's going to be the wrong roof angle, sure as hell. Where is my piece? There it is. Yeah, see, it's the wrong angle. Damn it! Damn it, damn it, damn it, damn it, damn it. Okay. So how is this even going to work? Because anything I sink in that roof is going to stick through the bottom. Yeah. And that'll look friggin' stupid. But I could easily just wall this off and just make this thing completely inaccessible. Let me just put this up here while I'm humming and trying to figure out what the frick is even happening here. So I put that there. What do I get for? There are barn house and roof walkways. Yes. You're talking about the roofs that are all the way at the end that's got the posts on the bottom. These. I mean, that wouldn't be bad. The posts would still stick through. You know. The main source of your game crash when you accidentally take off your main workbench. Like 17,000 pounds. Dude, I've carried 27 tons. I've got characters that have 300,000 pounds of stuff. Not a problem. Now, that's, to be fair, that's just food and junk. It's not every category of stuff. Namaste, Adama. How you doing? Welcome to the stream. How you doing, baby? How's it going? Nice build. Thank you, free pizza. Appreciate the nice words, dude. The kind words. Okay, so if I pull this up, wait. I actually kind of like that. Okay, well, let's try that. And where's the best place to get XP in survival? You're only level 8. Well, honestly, exploration is probably your best bet. At level 8, I'm generally... What am I doing at level 8? What did I do at level 8? I don't even remember what I did at level 8, so I can't tell you, dude. Sorry, I don't really remember what I did at level 8. But I do know that I go straight to. I always make a beeline for. Sunshine Tidings to get that thing. Killing the ghouls along the way and doing that all that stuff generally gets me some decent, nets me some decent XP, and then from there, questing really is your best bet because you get the most XP from that by a long shot. Go help dance, you know, work your way down to the police station. You know, kill the ghouls, go to Arc Jet, and have him kill all the sense for you. and then just rack up the XP that way. But well, let's see how this works. I'm on the wrong side of it too. Of course I am. Why would I not be on the wrong side of it? Duh. But honestly, at the start, if you can swing it, make a bunch of adhesive. Get your farm set up, get your farmer settlers going, and start making adhesive. And building. Building gives you quite a bit of XP as well, if you have the materials. But I generally don't blast past the low levels, because that's, for me, that's the most fun, you know? That's where I enjoy the game the most, because it's the hardest. Look at this shit. It will not let anything sink anywhere into that roof, into that corner. I thought maybe I could trick it by going this way, but that isn't going to happen. That is nuts. Look at that shit. As soon as anything just touches it. Okay. You know what? You are gonna do what I want, bitch. What? It won't even snap to itself? I'm sorry. What is even happening here? It literally will not snap to itself, guys. Maybe a different version of it will? There's this one, that's a corner. Isn't there one that's just plain? Yeah, that's the corner one. This one. Look at this. It will not... Oh, duh. It will not snap to itself. That is the weirdest... Only snap face to face? That is pretty stupid. I'm going to agree with you on that one, JPEG. So dumb, dude. So dumb. Okay, well... I don't know how this is gonna work, man. I've never heard of a piece that didn't snap side to side, but well, it just fucking works, doesn't it? It just works. Okay, well, I guess what we're gonna have to do then is leave our tools down here, and then because of course my brain is completely the consistency of smoothed out silly putty at this point. Let's go ahead and put my tools inside the garage so they don't get wet. Of course, they'll still get wet because the wind is getting treats rain. And we will come back next week with a fresh brain and hopefully more skill. I'm like, they don't snap side to side. Wait, what? SC, how you doing? Welcome to the stream. And thank you very much. Thank you very much. I'm glad it's giving you some stuff you can use for your bills, yeah? That's what we're here for, man. Well, that and, you know, the occasional comedic relief, but it's we're going to do this. So what we're going to do now, if you want to bail now, you can. What we're going to do is we're going to walk through the rest of the we're going to see what we built today. That's how we're going to do it. We're going to see what we built today. It's a very exciting part of the program, yes? Okay. So what we built today. Not a hell of a lot. What we did is we added an entryway for the bar, which is here. And we added another room to the hostel, which you go up here. And we just kicked out the wall. Well, we didn't kick out the wall. There was no wall here. And just put the little tube here of whatever, the tube of doom. Not much there. Yeah. And then... we used scaffolding pieces, JPEG's method, and his suggestions to scaffolding snap onto the top of this thing we built last week to put a guard station and a turret, hello turret, right here. So this guy can see, or girl, whoever, whatever, can see pretty much the entire approach from up top. There's no real way to get up here other than this quite yet, but whatever. And then what we added is we added the guard, the main... guards, security, barracks area thing, which to date is basically just an armor workbench sitting on a platform here. Another guard station up here. Let me turn the light on so you can see it. Which is scaffolding and warehouse and wood and metal and concrete and whatever. But this guard gets to see the main approach there and, you know, the side approaches there, plus whatever's out in the water. And they got themselves a tiny little room here, which is apparently a bear and whatever the frick. And I don't know what I'm going to do with this yet. This is going to be some kind of thing, I guess. Whatever. And then from the front, this little bad boy, the settlement now looks like this. So yeah, you can barely even tell there's water under there anymore. But we got different elevations. We got lots of mixed materials. It's looking fairly formidable. It's got a good balance of open air and clutter, which is nice, which is what I'm digging. And yeah, so next week, I guess what we're gonna try and do is yeah, that guard, man, he wouldn't want to mess with that. So I guess what next week's plan is gonna be is doing something with that roof. That's gonna be the thing, yeah. The roof is gonna be built up. Yeah. Okay, so I want to thank y'all for stopping by, sharing your Sunday with me for as long as you did, up to 3 hours in this case. If you had a good time today, I'd appreciate you clicking that like button. Let YouTube tell other people, hey, this guy's, he's an idiot, but he's fun, so maybe you want to watch him. If you're new to the channel, and this is the first thing you're seeing, and you like this kind of thing, click subscribe. There will be more of this kind of thing. I stream Fallout 4 Vanilla Building on Sunday, starting in Noon Central, which is this stream. And then on Tuesday evenings, about 7:30 Central, I'll stream something else. Currently, it is going to be the development of my Fallout 4 Vanilla No DLC building character, who has some very interesting problems to solve. And then, of course, I pop up on Friday sometimes, but those are totally random, so you can't depend on those. I want to thank y'all for subscribing, watching, and hanging out. Again, as always, I appreciate you all very much, and I will see you in the next one. Take care, y'all.